The NIH Metabolic Clinical Research Unit is one of the newest additions to the NIH Clinical Center in Bethesda, Maryland. It's the largest hospital in the world devoted totally to clinical research, research involving people.
It is really the most modern and cutting-edge place to do clinical research.
We have over 1,500 active clinical protocols going on.
Clinical research is important because it is the fundamental activity that we do to develop tomorrow's drugs and to improve healthcare and to improve medicine.
Occupying units on two floors of the clinical center, the metabolic unit will provide facilities for researchers to study the factors contributing to obesity and associated diseases.
We're facing an epidemic of obesity in the United States. At this time, 2 out of 3 people living in the U.S. are overweight. And 30% of them are characterized as actually being obese. This is a very serious problem because obesity leads to different kinds of diseases like diabetes, heart disease, and certain kinds of cancers.
The NIH supports a broad spectrum of obesity research, including molecular, genetic, behavioral, environmental, clinical, and population studies.
Well, in order to address the obesity epidemic, the institutes at the NIH got together to develop a strategic plan for obesity research.
As an important part of that plan, the metabolic unit will bring together experts from the fields of metabolism, endocrinology, nutrition, cardiovascular biology, gastroenterology, hepatology, genetics, and the behavioral sciences to pursue obesity research in a collaborative way.
We hope with time that this facility might be opened up to scientists and clinical investigators out in the broader community across the United States, some of our grantee institutions who are interested in obesity research as well.
There are complex networks that control eating behaviors and body weight. Researchers will look closely at what and how much people eat, and at the lifestyles and activities of obese and non-obese volunteers.
We're recruiting people of all weight categories, lean to very obese. In our research, we hope to destigmatize obesity because many people do believe that obesity is simply the result of failure of the will. People can't control their appetite. People can't motivate themselves to do exercise.
Somewhere between 50 and maybe 80% of all the variation in how much people weigh is really determined by their genetic inheritance. This other 50 to 20% is probably mostly due to what we call our shared environment. Genes, if you will, load the gun and then the environment pulls the trigger.
There are hormones that are affected. There are metabolic rates that are controlled by our nervous system that are all under genetic influence. And this is simply not just a failure of the will.
The new unit is unlike any in the country. It's been designed to accommodate the needs of patient volunteers and to precisely measure their diets and metabolism. The metabolic unit has 10 private inpatient rooms built with patient comfort in mind. The design of each room took into account the needs of patient volunteers with specially reinforced construction, amenities, and equipment.
So this is our exercise laboratory. In this space, we can study patients' ability to do exercise with their exercise capacities and their cardiovascular health.
And over time, while people lose weight, we can track the changes that occur and demonstrate improvement in their cardiovascular health.
One factor investigators will study is the relationship between obesity and sleep.
Subjects who sleep on average less than 6 hours tend to gain more weight over time than subjects that sleep longer. The goal of the study is very ambitious because if just extending sleep by an hour or so may lead to an healthier weight, we're going to have a treatment which is safe, inexpensive, and readily available.
Nutritionists will play a significant role at the unit as they analyze calories and nutrients in meals.
This is the Metabolic Kitchen. Here we prepare meals for patients, but they're not any old meals. Here we weigh and measure every single food item before serving it to patients. Before the cooks prepare the meals, dietitians calculate out the calories, the number of grams of protein, carbohydrate, and fat in the meals, and maybe even the amount of other nutrients, depending on what we're looking at in a particular study.
The communal dining area will allow researchers to monitor study volunteers' food intake.
In some studies, we ask the patients to eat all the food on their plate. In other studies, we would allow them to leave some food over. We would then take that food back here to this kitchen and reweigh what they did not eat.
Researchers will look at how eating behavior is influenced by these factors. The unit also has specially designed computerized vending machines.
These are not your normal vending machines. These are accessed via smart cards.
So you can select as much or as little of whatever you want to out of this vending machine any time of the day and night.
Because obesity is rapidly increasing in children in the U.S., this research comes at a critical time.
I'm very excited about this new unit and the opportunities we have, especially about the integration of children and adolescents in our studies.
Obesity is becoming more prevalent. Instead of being about 5% of children as it was back in the 60s and 70s, now it's up to about 17% being considered severely overweight, and another 15% at risk for overweight.
We see an increase of complications associated with obesity. One of the complications is type 2 diabetes, a condition that was previously only observed in adults, actually in older adults. Now we see type 2 diabetes in children as young as 9 years old.
Then we also try to study particular children who have weight troubles already to understand the reasons why they become overweight and develop particular strategies to help them lose their weight and prevent weight gain in the future.
Other tools available to researchers at the Metabolic Unit are the BOD pod and the DEXA.
Since we're measuring metabolism, we also want to measure people's body composition to as accurately as we can. So we use two systems to measure total body density with a BOD pod, or the air displacement technique. One subject can sit in here for about a couple minutes, and we measure the total body density. We also measure people's total body density as well as the regional distribution of fat, muscle, and bones using the DEXA machine.
The Metabolic Unit features three rapid response respiratory suites.
We will be measuring people's metabolic rate on a minute-by-minute basis over 24 hours. We will measure not only the amount of calories burned, but how you burn it in terms of burning carbohydrates versus fat versus muscle. This is an airtight, controlled environment, right? And we can pass the food, pass items you need in here through an airtight lock system.
The new metabolic unit at NIH will examine how factors such as diet, exercise, or sleep combine with genetics to determine body weight.
The clinical research will be going through here will help us understand the physiology, and we will link that with the genetics that determines how people are different, how you and I burn calories different. How can we optimize the next generation of strategies to prevent, to treat, and to keep the effectiveness of the treatment of the obesity?
Sounds good.
New and better treatments depend on clinical research, and that research depends on the volunteers who participate in studies.
Those volunteers are critically important because of the time that they give. It's really the most important aspect of us better understanding how to diagnose, to treat, and ultimately to prevent a number of human diseases that we're currently seeing in this country.
They can expect to be welcomed, to have a wonderful environment for their care, and in addition, they can expect that they're going to be participating in an exciting partnership between the physicians and all the care providers and the scientists.
We've provided for internet access for all of our participants. There's ample entertainment.
Volunteering to be a subject in clinical research is serious business, and they need to understand the risks and also the potential benefits for either themselves or for their family members or for the community at large.
I'm very much looking forward to the work here, especially because it's the integration of all age groups, of all ethnic groups, and so I think it's an all-around approach.
I'm really very, very excited, and I feel very fortunate to be in this environment because this allows us to do studies that probably in very few other centers can be done.
The National Institute of Diabetes, Digestive and Kidney Diseases was responsible for developing this unit. Is really proud to have these volunteers participate not only in these studies, but the numerous other studies that are involved, that are currently ongoing here at the Clinical Center in Bethesda.
For information on what we've already learned from obesity research, visit the Weight Control Information Network online. For anyone interested in volunteering for studies at the NIH Metabolic Clinical Research Unit or other studies at the NIH Clinical Center, call 1-800-411-1222 or visit clinicalstudies.info.nih.gov.